brothers and sisters. I come before you tonight as the preacher, the son of a preacher. Preacher immersed in the movement at 5 years old. I don't come tonight representing any organization, but I come to talk about faith and morality. I'm a preacher and I'm a theologically conservative liberal evangelical biblicist. I know it may sound strange, but I'm a conservative because I work to conserve a divine tradition that teaches us to do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with our God. I've had the privilege of traveling the country with the Reverend Dr. James Forbes and Reverend Dr. Tracy Blackman and Sister Simone Campbell. As we are working together in the revival and calling for a moral revolution of values. And as we travel the country and we see some things, that's why I'm so concerned about those that say so much about what God says so little, while saying so little about what God says so much. And so, in my heart, I'm troubled, and I'm worried by the way faith is cynically used by some to serve hate, fear, racism, and greed. We need to heed the voice of the scriptures. We need to listen to the ancient chorus in which deep calls unto deep. The prophet Isaiah cries out, "What I'm interested in seeing you doing," says the Lord, "as a nation is, pay people what they deserve. Share your food with the hungry. Do this, and then your nation shall be called a repairer of the breach." Jesus, a brown-skinned Palestinian Jew, called us to preach good news to the poor, the broken, and the bruised, and all those who are made to feel unaccepted. Our Constitution calls us to commit our government to establish justice, to promote the general welfare, to provide for the common defense, and to ensure domestic tranquility. Now, to be true, we have never lived this vision perfectly, but this ought to be the goal and the heart of our democracy. And when religion is used to camouflage meanness, we know that we have a heart problem in America. There have always been forces that wanted to harden, even stop the heart of our democracy. But there have also always been people who stood together to stir what Sister Dorothy Day called a revolution of the heart, and what Dr. King called a radical revolution of values. I say to you tonight, some issues are not left versus right or liberal versus conservative. They are right versus wrong. We need to embrace our deepest moral values and push for a revival of the heart of our democracy. When we hear
Justice for all. We can-